I came up with, as a songwriter, it's our gig to say, well, this is what they like, so you get inside their head. So I came up with some, like, fancy guitar riffs, like, and something nastier than. Okay, so, they fly me to Boston, a city with a lot of white people. They were riding at Joe Perry's house, where the studio was. And I show up, and there's Joe Perry in his house. And he was like a rock. He had like a wax chest. And his hair was like this. And he looked, and I made a noise like, ah, because he looked like a rock star. And you know, as you come, you guys don't really know me so well, but I could talk to shrubbery or a bench. I don't need an audience. I sit in my room and talk. So I go, Joe, what a great studio. Yeah. Well, you think the Red Sox ever beat the Yankees? Yeah. Hey, wanna, later on we go get some chowder, trying to be Bostonian. How about some chowder?
Mark the count.
Yeah. And I'm thinking, oh, Jesus. This writing session is going to be like kidney surgery. It's going to be like forever. Okay, so a car pulls up. The door opens up, backlit. There he was standing with childbearing lips. Yeah! And I thought to myself, thank God, someone like me. And we hit it off immediately. So he goes, well, what do you got? So I played him something with a riff. And he went like, yeah, yeah. Then he said, play me something else. Joe Perry
went, that's a good one.
Yeah,
what key is that?
Joe Perry went, yeah. And I'm thinking, I'm dying.
Four-way split on you.
Yes, no. Quarter. Okay, so Steven Tyler actually had the insight to say, I mean, I played him all my stuff with a riff, and he goes, I gotta ask you a question, man. What would you play if you were in Aerosmith? Like a member. I wasn't ready for that thing to happen. What would you do if you were in the group? So I suffered from HP, which is homosexual panic. I didn't know what it was. Oh, shit. I don't know what to do. So I remembered at that point in music, in the years, all the music was, let's hear it for the boys. And white people humping and footloose. It was tragic. Yeah, clapping on the 103. Just, they were so white, they were clear. So being a Beatle guy, I said, I kind of have this thing. And I played at a lower volume when I tell you to stop, so I'm telling, because I don't have the thing. So I played this thing on my guitar. And I'm thinking, I have this thing. Something's wrong with the world today. I don't know what it is. Something's wrong with our eyes. Thinking of John Lennon. We're seeing things in a different way. God knows it ain't his. Sure ain't no surprise. And yeah, I'm living on the... And Steven Tyler went, Stop! And I swear to God, I've never seen a mouth that big in my life. It was like a Chinese family having dinner on his tongue. So I make another noise like, yeah. He was engulfing. Yeah. So he said, we gotta play the John Lennon's in the room. John Lennon's in the room. John Lennon's in the room. So thank you, Sarah. So the song sort of wrote itself. Became a number one record. It sold millions of copies. I won a Grammy. It paid for my divorce and my penis implant. I got so many things. My penis implant. He was way too late. I'll do it. Just try it one more time, just for the humor. It won a Grammy. It sold millions of records. It paid for my divorce and my penis implant.
Okay. Take two.
Yeah, no, forget about it. Okay, so now I'm gonna do the song, and it's interesting because I wrote the song in the spirit of John Lennon because nobody was doing Instant Karma and Imagine and all that sort of stuff that he was about. And the song today actually makes more sense for what's going on in the world than it did when I wrote it. Yeah. So we're gonna do it now for real. Oh, but before we do, one more thing. Look at my scarf.
Awesome. Oh my gosh.
Oh, hey. Sarah, close your eyes, you're underage. Can you guys see that from, can you see that? Stare.
She's not impressed.
That was like a date for me. Okay. My age. No. The next time I get an erection, I'm going to shellac it. Okay. Here we go. I better shut up. Thank you. Goes like this. Something wrong with the world today. I don't know what it is. There's something wrong with our eyes. Seeing things a different way, and God knows it ain't his. It sure ain't no surprise. We're living on the edge. The light bulb is getting dim. It's meltdown in the sky. You can judge a person by the color of his skin. Mister, you're a better man than I. Said, fuck off and blow me. It was me.